after all, in the digital era. Very happy to be ushering in onto the stage Abhijit Bhavsar, Senior Manager, Manufacturing Consulting from Hitachi Vantara. It's over to you.
Welcome to the ET Global Digital League session. I'm Abhijit Bhavsar from Hitachi Vantara. I represent the manufacturing consulting team, and having worked in the area of digital transformation for the last 3-4 years, I'm here to share with you our perspective on digital transformation, as well as some success stories of clients who have progressed in the digital transformation journey in their manufacturing operations. A brief bit about Hitachi. While most of us know Hitachi as a product company, I think many of us do not know that Hitachi is also the 7th largest IT company. It's this combination of the operations technology understanding and the IT strength that we have, backed up with our consulting capabilities, that we are able to help clients realize potential from the digital transformation. In fact, one of our factories in Japan, Omika Works, has been recognized as an advanced 4th Industrial Revolution Lighthouse by the World Economic Forum. What this means is that this factory of Hitachi has proven itself to be a leader in deployment of Industry 4.0 technologies. Omika Works deploys a range of technologies, including about 80,000 RFID tags and a set of video analytics to improve productivity in their operations. Hitachi has also consciously been on the journey to develop IIoT platforms. From being a visionary in the Gartner for Magic Quadrant in 2018 and 2019, now Hitachi has been recognized as a leader among IIoT platforms. I think when it comes to digital, a lot of companies are already aware of the importance of digital. However, what we have seen and heard from various clients is there is a lot of difficulty in scaling the digital aspirations. A lot of companies have started doing proof of concept. Some companies have also gone ahead and done proof of values, where they have been able to derive benefits in limited kind of a implementation, but they have not been able to really explore the full scale of digital. One of the key things that we have observed in such kind of scenarios is the disconnect between digital and business objectives. The most successful companies who have been able to scale up their digital transformations have been able to link digital to their business objectives. This has been one of the key success factors for them, which is why we say that whenever you think about different aspects of a business, be it the market dynamics of the industry, what you are going to do as an organization, how do you innovate, how do you scale, all of it should be coupled with digital technologies as an enabler. Digital should not be a different kind of initiative in itself. It's a means to achieve your own business objectives. And hence, at Hitachi, we believe that it is a combination of both business approach as well as technology that leads to overall manufacturing excellence driven by digital technologies. We can look at the initiatives of Lean, Six Sigma, the total productive maintenance as our objectives, and then look at what technologies can help us drive those objectives or initiatives in our organizations. The right balance between these two gives us a set of solutions across health and safety, quality, production, and other functions. The right balance is important. So I sincerely request all my friends from the operations side to appreciate the benefits that technology can bring to the table, as well as I encourage all the friends from technology to look at business objectives, how technology can help fulfill business objectives to make this a symbiotic partnership. Talking of the journey to progress in digital transformation, we believe that it starts with data integration and analytics. Most of the people, they are looking at predictive and prescriptive capabilities to drive benefits. And it is true, a lot of benefits will accrue when organizations will develop predictive and prescriptive capabilities across different functions. However, the journey starts a bit earlier in the day. The first step of the journey is to have a data integration and analytics. We have to get the right kind of information and then start integrating across different applications so that we get a clear picture, a single version of truth, which in turn helps progress to the predictive and the prescriptive parts. The last bit is to have a customer inclusive and a symbiotic journey. For companies to reach to this destination, they should have a clear understanding of business objectives and look how digital can enable this journey. It has to be a multi-year roadmap. And not to forget, the important part is to fix basic systems and processes. I think all of us know that technology just is gigo, garbage in, garbage out. It magnifies what's underlying. So it's important to fix the underlying processes to ensure that we have the right kind of setup to embark on the digital journey. With that, I want to share the experience of one of our clients, a billion-dollar tire manufacturer. They are into off-road tire manufacturing, tires for products like excavators, forklifts, and so on. One of the key problems that they were facing was an issue of excess material consumption. So they were giving away, they were putting more rubber than was the specification on most of the tires. That translated into about 2% loss in their raw material cost. Further, they had a problem with their manpower productivity. A lot of the operations were manual, and it was difficult to figure out whether manpower deployed was productive or not. And lastly, as is a problem with many of the shop floors, they did not have a visibility on their overall equipment effectiveness, or OE for short. What we did is that we went to the client, we deployed our smart manufacturing platform, and also for end-to-end data capturing, which was integrated with a barcoding system. The idea was to track the product as it moves from raw material to the final dispatch through different stages. One of the key benefits that accrued from this kind of an approach was to give visibility to the operators on how the weight of different SKUs of tires was varying. Now, in this particular case, I would like to highlight that for off-road tires, it's a low volume, high variety kind of a business. So it is difficult to know which SKU is coming by and what its weight is supposed to be. And hence the visibility that was provided helped operators in adding the right amount of material in each stage, which actually helped 60% of reduction in the wastage that was occurring. Apart from that, there was also the aspect of having visibility on OEE and utility as well as consumable costs, which further helped the client to improve their productivity. The manpower utilization is also an interesting aspect, which I'll cover shortly in my next slide. So this is a schematic of the press shop that was there at the tire manufacturer. In a press shop, typically tires are loaded into curing presses, which apply the right amount of temperature and pressure so that the tires get their final shapes. These curing presses have a cycle time ranging from a few minutes to hours. In this case, what was happening is because to ensure that the presses were never empty, or to ensure the highest utilization, there was all in addition to the operator which was allocated to each press, there was also a handling team. So this handling team was tasked with the job of helping to put the tires into the presses. The problem was that the handling team had a lot of unproductive time, as highlighted by this red dots here. The reason was simple. In order to have the maximum uptime for the presses, it was essential that the handlers be available anytime the press becomes free. What we did is, with introduction of our solution, which was the digital platform, we started, we were able to get a visibility on when the presses would be free, when the handling team would be required. So as on account of this particular intervention, the handling team members who were unproductive and dedicated to each of the stations were optimized and converted into a much leaner central handling team, which had a visibility across all press operations in the shop floor. The handling team could see which press was in operation, where it was, where handling was required, where breakdown was required. This kind of a view enabled the operations team, centralized handling team, to be present at the right press at the right press at the right time, thus increasing productivity. As you can see, the number of sections have decreased considerably, as well as a manpower optimization was achieved through this. One of our other clients, an industrial goods manufacturer, came up with an interesting analogy of a challenge. The CEO mentioned to us that they manufacture transformers which are worth of lakhs of rupees, but still they do not have a visibility on the work order. So when the client asked, what is the status of my order, the CEO said that neither I am in a position to tell them when it can get delivered. But even other than that, I cannot even tell my client where exactly their product is in the entire value stream. And to compare with that, we live in an age where a pizza, from the time I order it to the time it is delivered, I have full visibility on that. With that kind of a problem statement in mind, we again got to work. We introduced the 3M traceability, where we were tracing man, machine, and material throughout the shop floor. We were tracing each work order on a single platform that we deployed for the client. What happened as a result of that, obviously the visibility improved for not only the organization, but also for the clients as to where orders were there. In addition to giving visibility, it also helped them prioritize orders that were getting delayed. And with a 20% improvement in schedule adherence through the system, they were also able to reduce their penalty costs. Obviously, with the kind of visibility that is available in this, in such kind of a system, they were able to figure out where the productivity losses were occurring, and they could enhance productivity by about 10%. All in all, we could see that they moved from a system of multiple Excel records to single version of truth, hidden losses, which became visible. At the time that was spent in data capturing and reporting was eliminated so that people could focus on more value-added aspects. Experience-based decision-making led to made way for fact-based decision-making. And while individual contribution, it was no way to track it, with KPIs coming in, performance management got strengthened. I think from these experiences, there are a few takeaways for the leadership. It is critical to set clear goals which are aligned to business visions. Following that, it is important to identify the areas of high impact. It is success begets success, and hence high impact areas would be the first should be the first one to be focused on. And as there is a need to prioritize key initiatives, so the implementation feasibility also needs to be looked into. The executive sponsorship, I would say, should continue unabated. I think that is a requisite not only for digital, but for any initiative that organizations wish to undertake. Lastly, I would say the focus on results should always be there. Digital is not something that needs to be marketed. It is something that enables you to meet your business objectives. So the result focus is imperative. And lastly, continue the journey through iteration and course correction. If you are interested in knowing where your organization stands in terms of the maturity for intelligent manufacturing, we have set up a small self-assessment platform, which will help you to know where you stand. Please reach out to us to know where you stand on your maturity journey, and we are more than happy to help you to start your journey and help you scale up in the journey. Thank you so much.